What's going on, everybody? I had a lot of requests after I just wrapped my brake rotors for the second time to do kind of a video tutorial. Now, I didn't video the whole process. I did take pictures during the process. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kind of mix some of those together and kind of show you what I did and what you can do and how easy it really is. Now, obviously, you can paint your rotors, you can powder coat them, and yes, you can wrap them. Now, you're gonna want a high temp brake wrap that's meant for calipers. You can't just use normal wrap. You have to use a high temp wrap for obvious reasons. It's on your brakes, it's gonna get hot. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a picture up of my previous wrap, which has been on the car for just about 2 years now. This one I used, I think it was like Icon, I believe it's a 3M wrap. It's a reflective wrap, which is kind of cool. When I first got it, I thought it was pretty neat. Basically, when a light hits it, it kind of glows, just reflective, like high visibility jacket, same thing. The problem with this wrap that I had was that it's super thick. Not only is it super thick, but it's super tacky. It was really, really hard to wrap the brakes. It's not as forgiving as most vinyl, where you can kind of put it on, take it off, reposition, heat up, reposition. It wouldn't let me do that at all. And I've wrapped a bunch of stuff, from emblems to interiors to even starting to wrap my own car. I didn't like the color, so I took it off. So the 2 years was pretty good. It started to crack recently. And I knew I wanted to change up the color and do something different, because it used to be people couldn't tell that it was wrapped, and now people are like, oh, it's wrapped, it's cracking, it looks like shit. So I decided to go with a different wrap this time. I went with more of an acid green, lime green, kind of the same paint that I used on my M3, but maybe a little bit brighter. I bought this wrap from Vivid, VVID, I believe is the name of the company. They're very, very, very well known in the wrap world for their products. Really easy stuff to use. And I had a great experience using it on the brakes. I was able to put it on, take it off, reposition it with no issues. And it basically just turned out 1,000 times better than my old yellow wrap. So I'm really glad I did it. I went with 2 feet by 2 feet. They say you can get done normally with 1 foot by 2 feet or whatever it is, or 1 foot by 1 foot, but I'd rather have a little extra than have to wait and reorder it. So I did have a little bit extra left over, not enough to do another caliper, so I'm glad I went with 2 feet by 2 feet. Ended up only being $40, so real, real cheap. And obviously it looks pretty good. Next step, obviously, you can get any sticker to put on the vinyl, whether you use Brembo or your car manufacturer. I went with the Porsche ones only because the Cayenne and the Touareg share a lot of parts built in the same factory, blah, blah, blah. I know. They're very, very similar, and I kind of like the fact that they share the same brakes and the same part numbers and everything. So I've gotten a lot of compliments on them before, and people are surprised. Oh, you put Porsche brakes on there? No, it's really the same thing. So regardless, you can put whatever you want on yours. I went with Porsche ones on mine. You can always change it. Not a big deal. They are factory Brembos. So let's get started. Obviously, first thing you want to do is you want to jack up your car. Jack up the vehicle. Put a jack stand under, make sure everything's safe. I don't like leaving the jack up, obviously. If you work on your car, you know why. So jack up the car, make sure everything's good, take the wheel off. Now is also a good time to clean your wheels inside and out. I like doing this because the inside barrels get really dirty and you can't really clean them too well when the wheels are on. So anytime I have wheels off, I like to clean the insides as well. So good time to do that. So go do that. Also a good time, if you do have a Volkswagen, you're familiar with these little plastic caps, they kind of pop off and break off. It's a good time to either replace those if you need to, or re-glue on the chrome caps onto the plastic. Good time to replace those, so I did that as well. Doesn't apply to you, don't worry about it. Next thing you want to do is you want to clean off your brakes. Obviously, like I said, mine have been wrapped previously. That was pretty easy to take off, like a normal wrap, peeled it off pretty easily. Left a little bit of sticky residue on some spots, but other spots not too bad. So clean that off. I used purple powder on mine, sprayed it, wiped it down, and then before I wrapped, I used a little bit of nail polish remover to make sure that there was no sticky stuff left. You might not have to do that because chances are, if you're watching this, you've never wrapped your brakes before to have residue on them. So clean that off, make sure that's all good. Next, you want to take your wrap and cut a good size piece that's going to cover probably 3/4 of the brake. Now, I learned this after my first time wrapping my other ones, is there's no clean way to do this with one piece. Don't try it. Don't do it. I did. It turns out like shit. Don't do it. It's easier to cut and do a second piece and overlay on top, so you have one piece on the front and one piece on the top, than it is to do one piece and flex it all the way over. Just for brakes, it doesn't work, and the seam is super small. You're not gonna see it. It's not worth it. You'll get a better result by doing the front and then doing the top, trust me. So you're gonna put your front piece on, position it so you got a little bit hanging on the top and a little bit hanging on the bottom, so that you can kinda stretch it and make sure it'll fit. That's another reason why it's easier to go with a bigger sheet from the beginning, so that you don't miscalculate and have to put extra squares on. And you're basically just gonna take your time, take heat around the edges, and contour the spaces. This wrap, like I said, is a lot easier. So what you do is you take your heat gun, you heat it up, and kind of work your way around the objects. Obviously, make sure you take off the brake bleed valve screw, not the screw, but the cap. Take that off and wrap around that. You'll have to cut a little piece for that to poke through later on, but the seam will sit behind it, and when you put the cap back on, you're not going to see it. So got it pretty well wrapped. Don't worry about the ends. Like I said, you are going to cut part of it down. So where it starts to kind of crumble up and peel on the inside, you're going to cut that flush and make it flat and set yourself up for your next piece. Then what you're going to do is take another piece and put it on the top and continue to wrap. Like I said, this is the best way to do it. I haven't seen someone wrap a caliper like this all one piece and turn out well. It's really hard to do. Use two pieces. Once you do the top and the bottom, and if you have any middle pieces, then you can kind of put everything back together, and then you can put your stickers on. Pretty easy. Now, one of the reasons I do like this more than paint, everyone's like, oh, why don't you use paint? It's faster, it's easier, it lasts. Yes, it does. I've painted calipers before. My M3s are painted. I'm not gonna change the colors on them, and chances are I'm not going to return it back to stock and sell it anytime soon. So actually, I'm not going to sell it at all. So what I like about the wrap is, just like wrapping a vehicle, you can take it off. It protects the stock caliper. It's not all nicked up, scratched up, dirty. I can bring it back to stock if I decide to sell it at any point and someone doesn't have to get a Touareg with bright green Porsche brakes. I'm pretty sure that's not going to really help my resale value. That's why I like the wrapping over painting. Over powder coating. Powder coating is probably the best option for this sort of finish, keeping the strength of the brakes and making them look the best. I agree. If I didn't use this car as a daily and I had a week plus downtime where I could take the calipers off, take the lines off, ship them out, get them powder coated and rebuilt, because you want to rebuild them at that point, have them come back, put them back on, rebleed the brakes, you're talking a week, sometimes 2 weeks for this whole process. And for a car that's a daily driver, I don't have that sort of time, downtime to not drive my car. So I don't want to do that. The wrapping is cheap. Like I said, it's about $40 versus probably 50 to 80 per caliper of powder coating. And I've already went over the pros and cons of painting as well. So it is a good option. If you're watching this, it's a good option. I try it. It does take time. Take your time. Obviously, you don't want to do what I did on my first one and try to wrap it with one piece. Have lots of shitty lines and wrinkles, and then it crack over time. I have heard people who have wrapped theirs or had them professionally wrapped, and they're 2 years, 3 years, 4 years even of it holding up. So it does hold up if you use the right material. Now, I literally just wrapped these last week, so I can't be a I can't tell you how long this wrap will last as of right now. I can come back to the video in another year and let you know how they hold up, but I guess you'll just have to try it yourself. Thanks guys for watching. Like and subscribe, and also don't forget to take a look at my recent impact video that just went up last week. Thanks again.